Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back. You're watching for today. So finally, Google released their stable Android 16 update for all Pixel series devices. We already reviewed beta 1 update after flashing it just around. But today we got something special. This is new ROM called as WitAqua. This is one of the first ROM which added special Android 16 features in custom ROMs after Evolution X. Last 10.5 update of Evolution X added new cinematic effect of Android 16 wallpaper customization. We'll find the review of that build in the icard video. Today we got this new ROM which can be considered as one of the smoothest AOSP ROM with the features of Android 16. We have given officially supported devices list along with its custom JSR ROM link in the video description, which will work for all Android devices. We reviewed everything related to this ROM, its features, its performance, and at the last, we've shown some bugs of the JSR ROM. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. We booted this JSR on our beloved OnePlus 9RT. You can also boot and test these ROM features on any device. For that, please check icard video for detailed instructions. We will first check out about device details of this new update released by this new ROM. This is Android 15 QPR2 based treble droid JSR build. Its version is 2.2. Security patches of this ROM is of latest June 2025. Build date of ROM is of 9 June 2025. So everything is updated with the latest source code. As I am using this ROM first time, I tested every essential features and all are working well, like Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi hotspot, Bluetooth, NFC, GPS. These features are working good. Next, all sensors are also working. Major essential features like display multi-touch, ear proximity, ear speaker, mic, charging, everything is working very well. There are some issues you may face if you are using JSR build. You can check that in details from bug section of this video. But before that, we will check out all the features of this ROM. Though this is a newly released pure AOSP ROM, they already added customization section called as witaquamagic section, where you will find all the customizations related to themes, lock screen, status bar, quick settings, miscellaneous, etc. But as this is the latest release, most of the section didn't have much features. They will be available with new build releases. For now, I especially liked its quick setting panel, transparency control, and miscellaneous setting, which has lots of spoofing features. In the system and under the buttons, we get the new long swipe back gesture feature. Except that all other old school gestures are also available here. These are minimal and essential features available in this ROM. With upcoming updates, they will add more features. But as already told in the intro, this is the first ROM which added few of new Android 16 features. You can overview these user interface changes only for quick setting and setting application in this ROM. This is the only ROM which got this real expressive design of Android 16 QS panel. Here we get on and off toggle animations like Android 16. Design of all the tiles look similar like Android 16. Tiles edit page seems similar with Android 16 edit page, along with the blurred background while accessing QS panel. Only brightness slider didn't got the actual look of Android 16 brightness slider. Setting panel is revamped with the Android 16 settings panel look. On and off switch toggles have same X like logo for off toggles. Setting option pages have more rounded cardish look. Apps info option have this new Android 16 like rounded buttons. These few changes absolutely gives feel of Android 16 for your device. In future, developer will definitely add more Android 16 expressive design look to volume panel, brightness slider, and they will also add new wallpapers, customization, etc. Another noticeable change I found about its performance. This is highly optimized JSR build, which is flying like a rocket on your fingertip. Everything is pretty smooth. Now let's talk about the bugs of this ROM. all OnePlus devices will not get working color slider in this JSI. Unfortunately, Google Circle to search is also not working, but Google Gemini Assistant is working fine. But by using the icard video tutorial, you can enable Google Circle to search in any device running with any ROM. Fingerprint unlock is not working, but face unlock is working. Google Photos Unlimited Backup is not working, even though we enabled the unlimited photo backup option available in the miscellaneous setting of customization option. ROM didn't passing Play integrity checks. Google Play Store is uncertified, but Widevine is L1. It's strange, and all banking applications are also working perfectly, even though Play integrity checks are failed. Maybe this is because of locked bootloader spoofing feature of this ROM. Bug of 2G calling is also present in this ROM. 4G internet is working good, but whenever we make a call, network switches to 2G network only. This is a major issue, I think. Remember, these bugs may or may not be same for all other devices which are running with this JSI. Devices which have dedicated support of this custom ROM may not face any kind of such bugs. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you like our work. I am waiting for new Android 16 custom ROMs and JSI. Once they will be available, I will review all of them. So please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.